you and now listening to Carve. You and now listening to Carve. You and now listening to Carve. You and now.
Yeah. Carve Radio, the vibe too strong. The type you never could deny, whichever side you on. Yeah. That's why we writing these rhymes. These youngin' get so in love with the shine. I still remind. We on it, it's my time. Yeah, I still remind.
Every day we on it, it's our time.
Hello and welcome to the Carve Podcast Series. I'm Celeba Maifadi. I'm hanging out with Nombulelo Fox. We just had an amazing conversation about all things beauty, hair care, the whole click saga, you know. But most importantly is that we're here to feature and find out what's for lunch at a beautiful, beautiful restaurant in the heart of Sandton. It's called Ethos Restaurant. Chef Sawan is here with us and he's prepared a couple of amazing dishes that he's going to talk us through. Hi, Chef. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you. Thank you very much for having me with
you. Thank you so much for letting us and allowing us to come through, to come and try out your signature dishes. I mean, everything looks so scrumptious. It's like, I'm just ready to dig in.
Yeah, it looks good. Yeah.
Right? Chef, tell us a bit about what's on the menu. What are we seeing here?
Okay, what we have is some of our signature dish, like you have said earlier. These are our first goals. Everyone that come here want to try our grilled octopus, which you have here.
That's
a grilled octopus. We braise it slowly for 2 hours and then we grill it. It goes with a nice roasted baby potatoes, fava bean, red pepper puree and red onion puree.
Is that the same as what we get in the seafood mix? That's
Malay. Yes, that's the same octopus that goes in our seafood platter, yeah.
Okay.
And then the second dish that we have, it's a ostrich carpaccio with some orange dressing, orange segment, parmesan, grated parmesan, and fresh rocket.
It looks like bacon.
It actually does.
Or biltong, like a bacon biltong type of thing. Yeah, what kind of texture does it have?
It's a very, very, it's a ostrich is quite raw in a way, so it's strong, but it's very nice in flavor. And we have done it with some balsamic pearl and pomegranate dressing, so it's
not something you cook.
No, it's a raw meat that it's very tender.
Okay.
It's very nice. Yeah.
Okay.
And then as a main, we have given you the sea bass curry.
Mm-hmm.
The sea bass come all the way from the island from where I am, Mauritius.
Mauritius.
Yeah. So it's grilled, and then we have a very nice curry, not spicy but full of flavors, served with baby spinach, tomatoes, and butternut.
Mm.
And it goes with a nice roasted yemista. It's a Greek stuffed tomato with rice that is baked with herb, meat, and everything.
Oh, that sounds good.
And as dessert is our signature dessert, which is a coconut. We call it a coconut.
It's like a cocoa ball.
Yeah.
So it's a coconut. I'm not going to tell you more about it. It's all about the experience. So once you break it, then you'll see what we are.
Sure. So okay,
let's start with your octopus.
I'm ready to dig in. Let's do this. Okay, let's start with the octopus, right?
And together with that, you have a very nice glass of Chardonnay that will accompany it very nicely. And
is that the best thing to have when it comes to pairing when you're having a substance or something from seafood?
Yes, it's more, the white Chardonnay is much better with octopus and the curry.
It
blends up nicely. Yeah.
No? Well,
if we were going to have some meat, I would have given you a nice Merlot.
Mm-hmm.
But as we are having some seafood, so the wine will be great. Yeah.
That's so tender to even cut through.
Okay, there we go. This is amazing. It's just butternut. It's just potatoes.
It's a fava bean. It's a bean, a dry bean that we cook slowly also with lots of herb, and we puree it. So yeah. And then you got the Hasselbank potato.
A pureed dry bean.
Yeah.
What's it called? A hassa?
Fava bean. Yeah.
Fava bean.
Yeah. Mm. That's also a Greek, it's more, as our restaurant is a Greek inspired, but we do Mediterranean also. So it's Greek inspired Mediterranean food.
Yo.
So we didn't try to just have a Greek food and being signature as a Greek restaurant, you know, we don't break plates.
You don't break plate.
Yeah.
Tell us about your menu. Like, what inspired all the dishes that you've put together into the menu?
So it's more, like I said, we've been open since in November last year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and unfortunately with COVID, we had to close down lockdown, but we used the lockdown as a part of the planning to reopen. So we use that time to revamp our menu.
Mm-hmm.
That's when I joined the group, and we took some of the dishes that was already here,
yeah,
and we just twist it and work it out with some of my flair that I have with my experience. So it's more the original that they had with a little bit of my experience and my flair. So it's more Mediterranean, some of the island around Mediterranean.
Nice.
So to just get it. And
speaking of your flair, we know you've been in South Africa for over 20 years. You're from Mauritius, but when did you start your journey with food?
Oh, I started very young when I was 20 years old, mm-hmm. back in Mauritius, did the hotel school, and from there worked only 2 years in Mauritius,
mm-hmm.
and then I jumped on the plane and went to Seychelles for 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
I had a very good opportunity.
Wow.
So Seychelles, 5 years, that's where I grew in the industry with a kitchen, in the culinary, in this cuisine.
Mm-hmm.
I worked with chef from Europe and from Australia and Asia.
Mm.
That's where I've learned all my trademark and everything. And from there, I came to South Africa, worked in Joburg for Emperor's Palace, went to Cape Town for Sun International, worked for the very nice restaurant Sebruga, and came back here, worked for the Legacy Group, and now I'm here with Ethos, and looking forward to have a very long time with them and growing the business with them. So yeah, looking forward to put the Ethos on the map.
Yes,
go back.
Put that Ethos on the So when it comes to all the meals that you make, do you find yourself leaning more towards Mediterranean because of your background and where you've been, or do you grill a steak here and there?
No, more on the Mediterranean side. You know, it's we don't want to be known as a steakhouse in a way. That's why we have all the flavors put in place. So a little bit of seafood, little bit of meat, and we add that extra blend of spices and herbs that come from Mediterranean cuisine.
Well, let's get that octopus that is got that extra something. Let's taste it, okay?
So now you have the carpaccio. So yeah. Again, it's a blend of ostrich. It's a ostrich is a local game.
Mm-hmm.
So
yes,
with that, we have done the flavor of the Mediterranean. So a little bit of a blend of local and Mediterranean. So, yeah.
What's this fruit? Is it orange?
Orange, yeah. That's orange segment. And you have an orange dressing on it. So.
Orange dressing as well?
Yes.
Mm.
How does it taste?
Tastes amazing. Mm. Like when you get those flavors get together in there.
Yeah, so it's all about the blending. You know, we don't want to really say we are fine dining, because fine dining comes with a trademark, and people are quite scared when they walk in, oh, fine dining.
You get a bit like scared. You're like, okay, I'm definitely going to get small portions, things that are not going to be filling.
Yeah, so how do you
mirror that balance? How do you make sure that as much as the food doesn't look too overwhelming, but that at the end of the day, it's still too filling?
So that's what we, like I said earlier, it's all about all the flavors that we put in together on the plate. Mm-hmm. And it's not just small thing to, when the people come, you still eat, you're full, and you still had a five-star experience and a nice fine dining experience.
I'm definitely feeling that five-star experience. I am feeling it. It is so good.
So you don't get intimidated when you walk in here.
Yeah.
All the things. So we have a nice blend into the service, into the food and the experience.
Mm. But you know, chef, to be honest with you, in South Africa, I don't know if we really eat our meat unless it's biltong, without it being cooked. That's the only that's the only time we'll have meat that's not cooked. So how is this possible with this ostrich?
Like I said, we try to be adventurous.
Yeah.
That's
who's ever tried this?
Like, we are adventurous and try to get it out there and And also it's an education process of our guests and try new things. And be adventurous like what we are. So to be able to blend and have a little bit more of the usual that they have in the other places.
I've certainly never had that. Have you?
I haven't personally. I think the closest thing, as you were saying, was definitely biltong.
Yeah.
I'm a person who's very fussy. Like, I know even with my steaks, I know you guys are probably going to judge me. I eat mine.
Well done.
But this is
almost like dry. This is amazing. Dry it out.
Yeah, I do.
So again, like I said,
this is amazing.
Adventurous.
Yes.
Educational in a way of what
you're having. Is it not overwhelming though? Like when you see something on the menu, chef, like all these amazing words that you're saying, the only thing I'm getting is ostrich, octopus. Everything else, the guja, I'm just like, no. I don't know what you're saying.
It came with experience. It came with a lifeline of cooking for so long.
Yeah.
And cooking for lots of great people in the country. So that builds the confidence to be
Speaking
able to
Who's the ultimate celeb or superstar or someone who you've always wanted to be that you've made food for?
In my career, I've cooked for Samuel L. Jackson.
Wow! Come on! With it.
I did when during the World Cup we had the Spain team when they were here, so we did cook for them also.
When they were here, the World Cup of
2010, yeah.
When you were saying Spain will feel the pain,
yes. That's when
and we felt the pain.
Yes.
We were like, Spain will feel the pain. Next minute, SA feeling all that pain.
So for them, and also I did cook for the Mandel family.
Nice.
Oh, okay.
Mandel family. Mm-hmm. I cooked for Kalema, the former president. And other distinguished.
Wow.
Yeah,
so. Hey, you're a big shot, aren't you?
I tried.
That's nice. We're so proud to be eating your food. I mean, it's just
amazing.
Got that thing. What's next?
Let's try your curry and then you can finish up a bit later. So
at least you can have a taste of the
curry. Okay, let's try the curry. What's in here?
You need to taste it because, like I said, I'm not going to give it away for you to spoil the experience.
Okay.
When we talk about curry, we got one certain feel about it, mostly in South Africa.
Chef, how am I going to break it up and make the pots at the same time? How do we do that?
How do you eat it?
Yes.
You need to start from there.
I need to start here.
Start from there.
Okay.
That's you have your fish and some of the sauces.
So,
okay.
Do we use this?
Use that also, yeah.
I've always been so confused on how to use this.
Hey, bro, I don't even know.
You go.
What to use? Is it okay, chef?
You go wild.
Do you get offended when people don't use the right cutlery to be eating your
really
food?
It's all about, you know, eventually we get to learn and we know what it is. But like I said, we don't want to be intimidated with the setting and all these things. Because if you go to a fine dining place, there's so many settings done you don't want to know where are you going to start, where you're going to finish. So
that is my problem.
Yeah.
That is something I battle with. That's why I'm just like, you have to forgive me.
So, yeah. So, like I was saying, with the curry, people try to think when they're having a curry, they have only one thing in their mind, spiciness.
Soup.
You know, we all, especially in South Africa, when you said, you're going to have a curry, the first thing come in mind, Durban.
Yes.
Durban and all its spices and everything. Mm. But we try to, the dish that I put in place is a blend of local and the Mediterranean cuisine that we are doing. So you have the spices, but you don't have that spiciness that's going to make you feel like it's so hot that you one bite and then you want to have something else.
And the dish becomes so overwhelming.
There's
this
buttery substance in here, some buttery substance.
So we do have some cream in the sauce. Mm.
It's making the pot, eh?
Yeah.
Mm.
How does it feel? And the fish is very nice. It's soft.
It feels good. It feels good to my heart, chef.
Lovely. That's great.
Do you ever get people dancing? What are the weirdest reactions that you get when people taste your food?
The best thing that I can see when I came around and see and meet with my guests is that there's nothing left on the plate.
Mm-hmm. That's what's up.
That is the best feeling because then you know that we have done our work and the guests have enjoyed and nothing is left.
I dance. When I have really good food, I dance. I think a song just cues in my head and I just
You got a happy song.
That's exactly what's happening here. This is so amazing.
Lovely.
You said this is the sea bass, right?
It's a sea bass, yeah. It's farmed in Mauritius. And it's not, it's very soft, it's in texture, it's not dry. Even, like I said, we grill it first and then we put it in the sauce, so you still have a balance of it.
This is from Mauritius?
From Mauritius.
How do you get such, like, importing food? Let's talk about that, importing food and the difficulties of that.
We got certain of our suppliers that we work with, that we tell them that these are the ingredients and these are the products that we're going to use, and they source it for us, and then we get it. So. It is very competitive.
With the whole lockdown and how COVID-19 had, everything was closed. The borders were closed, shipping, nothing could come in. So
that's how we are starting. That's why we did our official opening last week on Wednesday.
Yeah.
Then because we knew we were going to start getting all our product and we didn't want it to really open up not having the proper product and the proper ingredients.
Because that was going to be messy because, you know, you can't be letting people try out amazing food and then you can't be consistent and giving us that amazing food.
Now we know that going forward, we're on level 2, we're going on level 1.
Very soon.
Very soon. So we are rocking. We are ready to go and take it to another level.
So, Chef, this is your spring-summer menu?
Yes, yes.
Are you going to do heartier dishes when we get to winter or are you not fazed by that? Do you just always just bring out these amazing flavors?
This is our a la carte menu. That's what we have put in place. And as we go along, we're going to have our special and everything. We didn't want it to go on an extensive menu.
Yes.
Because, you know, too much, it's too many.
Too many options.
So we try to keep it as simple as possible. Yeah. And from there, we're going to add up all our special and get going with that. So one day, depending on summer and winter, any season, we're going to bring in our specialties and get the dishes going. Lean and not, it's flavorful, but not full in a way that you're going to eat it and feel
it's not overwhelming. It's okay. It's perfect.
Yeah, and we balance it in the portioning and all these things. So
I love it.
You eat it, you still feel that you have a very good meal, but you don't feel like now you just want to
see. Now you want to see. Exactly.
Can I tell you about my sweet tooth? Like, my sweet tooth is distracting me.
So now you're gonna go to the ultimate experience.
Because my sweet tooth is always distracting me.
So
I can eat, I have a combo, Chef. You need to maybe think of incorporating my combo into your meal. I have a popcorn and ice cream combo. And I have that almost every night. I put ice cream and popcorn together.
What?
Yes.
That is a new thing for me. I need to try that, Chef, you know? We always share ideas.
The next thing is the best seller.
We'll name it after you.
Yes. Think of doing something there, maybe freezing it or making a popcorn, whatnot. But this looks so amazing. It's a cocoa ball.
So this is a coconut.
Coconut.
Have you seen a coconut before?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I have.
You have to break the coconut.
Okay, so how do I break the coconut? Okay.
And then you break the coconut.
Take a hammer. This way. I break it this way.
You just go and break it, yeah.
How soft? So what's the texture?
You go for it and then you see. So go for it.
Okay, that is very hard.
Go one. Come on. Go for it.
I'm scared. Yes. I am seeing caramel and that amazing things.
So this is our signature dessert, okay? It's called a coconut on the menu. It goes with a nice caramel sesame seed mousse inside. And it's done out of a meringue on the outside. So like I said, if I would have told you this earlier, the experience would have been the same. So now, you know, it's all about the intriguing and what you get inside.
This is very creative.
It's better than the popcorn and the ice cream.
Yeah. It beats it by far. This is so amazing. So how do you put in this substance into the cakes? Like, I'm sure making this must be such a...
It is a bit of a process. But we got a very nice pastry chef that can help us here. And it's done as a meringue. We set it up half-half and then we combine it. So we do the cream inside and then we combine it.
You know, Chef, one of the amazing things that I like to see when I'm watching, I don't know, like a food show, is just the intricacies and layers and things that they go through.
The creativity
Like molding things and 1, 2, 3 and putting in and all of that. For you, I mean, are you, from what I see on some cooking shows, that the chefs can be quite quite brutal.
Yeah.
And right now you are smiling. So I wonder, how are you in the kitchen?
It all depends on the shows that we are putting on.
Just for the right now, you know.
Right now, you're just being nice. You're like, okay.
You see the front face. When I'm at the back in the kitchen,
it's go time.
Yeah, it's go time. And especially when it's a busy time and it's, you know, when the pressure is on. So we need to be on top of our game so that we don't have any interference and we are on time with giving the best to the front of house. So that's where when the stove is hot, you feel the heat.
Right. Well, let's not keep you because I'm seeing a lot of people are starting to come in and they obviously want to get that Chef Sawan's hand touching the food and doing the most. Thank you so much for allowing us to come through to this place again. The food is absolutely amazing. You know, we wish you all the best and all the success with this beautiful restaurant. And yeah, I guess we'll pop in some other time, right?
Lovely. Looking forward for that. And thank you very much for having me and having the Ethos restaurant with you and for scouting us. So looking forward for much more.
Thank you so much. Yeah. And that's how we wrap up today's episode of What's for Lunch. We are at Ethos restaurant. I need to finish up this amazing dessert. So yeah, check you on the flip side. Do interact with us on @Carve_Africa on all social media platforms. You know what to do, you know. We'll hit you up, let's comment, let's have a vibe, let's do the right thing. Thanks everyone.